Everybody to this open level vinyasa class. I always like to emphasize that it's do what feels for your body, and I'm really happy to see some familiar students. And if you're new to my class, just know that I want you to do what feels best for your body, and I'll certainly show you some modifications and feel free to change it up. Yoga is not about the pose, and as you know, just do what you can. Okay, so let's get started. First of all, happy Earth Day. And in celebration of today's theme, we're going to incorporate fire, air, earth, and water into our themes today in recognition of our planet. And so let's get started. I invite you now to get into a comfortable cross-legged seated position. Feel free to take your back against the wall now that you have the opportunity to use full resources of your home, and either place your palms face up on top of your knees or your palms face down, whatever feels right for your body. So the palms face up, I always like to go over, is just a symbol of receiving energy from our community and the universe at large. Maybe you need to ground your energy, maybe you feel a little bit scattered today, that's okay. And once you choose the position of your hands, the yoga mudra, just close your eyes, see if you can sit with the tall spine, that way you can bring more oxygen to your brain. And just allow yourself, give yourself permission to be here in this moment. Let go of any distractions in the home. Let go of any distractions that are going outside of your home, or maybe they're in your mind, and just start to notice your body in space. As you feel connected on your mat, notice the air surrounding your body. Maybe you notice the parts of the body that are not connected on your mat and where the air can glide underneath. See if you can feel that connection. And then feel one line of energy up from the crown of the head, down through the back of the neck, down through the back of the spine, and out through the tailbone. Gently shift your attention now to the emotional part of your well-being. Notice what kind of energy you brought onto your mat here today, and just feel it. Oftentimes, the body is sending us so many powerful messages about what's going on inside, and we disregard them or ignore them in our hurried or busy state. See if you can tap into those messages, those thoughts and feelings, and don't shy away from it. Just feel more, breathe more. Good. Now, today I'd like to introduce to you a pranayama technique. It's called Kapalabhati breath. It's an energizing breath. It's breath of fire. It brings vitality into our system. Breath is prana in yoga. It's our life force. It's qi in Japan, and it's qi in China. So it's really important, especially in these unprecedented times, to really just bring more oxygen into our cardiovascular system. So from here, bring your thumbs up into the air, almost like you're hitchhiking, and you're gonna breathe in sharply through the nose and out through the nose. So as a count, in a count of five, and hopefully you can see my belly, you're gonna pump it in and out. So it looks like this. So that was five breaths. Let's do five rounds together. Begin now. Five, four, three, two, one. Exhale. Good. Fourth round. Bring the thumbs up. So it's really hard for me to talk and do the breath of fire at the same time, but it looks like this. Good. Three more rounds. And if you, for some reason, need to grab a tissue, that's completely normal. Feel free to grab a tissue. What you're doing is you're detoxifying the body. Go ahead and do it again. Pump the navel in and out. Five, four, three, two, one. Exhale. Good. Two more rounds. Good. One more round. Thumbs up. Exhale all the air out and pump. Sharply in through the nose and out through the nose. Last round. Here we go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Exhale, exhale. Let it go. Close your eyes here for a moment. And I just want you to feel the effects of Kapalabhati breath. This is a 5,000-year-old practice, and it all began with this. Learning to focus on the breath. The breath is your guide. Feel free to use this as a tool, even if you're feeling lethargic or down. Nice. With the palms face down on top of the knees, you can continue to close your eyes or keep a soft gaze towards the tip of your nose, or open up your eyes as you slowly begin to rotate the head. Like you're drawing little circles up to the ceiling. And feel free to linger shoulder to ear if that feels good. Don't forget to switch the rotation. Bring yourself back to a neutral spine. Let your throat face up to the ceiling and enjoy a nice stretch in the back of the neck and the decompression in the front of the throat. Good, one more cleansing breath and bring your head back to a neutral position. Sweep your arms up high to the sky, reach tall through the fingers. And as you exhale, sweep your right arm behind your back, let your left hand fall on top of your knee. Good. 5 big breaths in our twisted spine, and I'm gonna come onto the mat now so that you can see me. Inhale, exhale one, inhale, exhale two, inhale, exhale three, inhale, exhale four, inhale, exhale five. Reach your arms back up high to the sky, and now twist over to the left. The hand can fall down on top of the kneecap or down to the ground, whatever feels right. Here we go. Inhale, exhale one, inhale, exhale two, inhale, exhale three, inhale, exhale four, inhale, exhale five. Good. Reach your arms high to the ceiling and now forward fold. Let your head and your neck hang heavy as you breathe deep into the hip flexors and also into the joints. Here we go. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale two, inhale, exhale three, inhale, exhale four, inhale, exhale five. Reach your arms back up high to the sky. Let the right arm fall down by your hip and sweep your left arm up and overhead, reaching tall past the fingers. Here we go. 5 breaths. Inhale, exhale one, inhale, exhale two, inhale, exhale three, inhale, exhale four, inhale, exhale five. Reach your arms back up high to the ceiling. Now lean over to the left side. You can bend the elbow and set the forearm flat if you'd like to get a little bit deeper into the hips. Here we go. Inhale. Exhale one. You can look straight ahead or up towards the ceiling. Inhale. Exhale two. Inhale. Exhale three. Inhale. Exhale four. Inhale. Exhale five. Good. Reach your arms back up high to the sky. And now take the fingers on top of the shoulders and twist to the right. Good. 5 twists. Inhale. Exhale one. Twist to the left. Inhale. Exhale two. Inhale. Exhale three. Inhale. Exhale four. Inhale. Exhale five. Good. Now make your way seated on your mat with the soles of the feet down. Your hands are right next to your hips. Option one, you can come into reverse tabletop as you lift your pelvis off the mat. Let your head and your neck hang heavy. Or option two, lengthen the legs straight out on the mat and push down through the palms. The soles of the feet are flat as you ground down through the feet, coming into this reverse plank. 3 breaths. Here we go. Inhale. Exhale one. Inhale. Exhale two. Inhale.
exhale, three, beautiful, gently release, set your pelvis back down onto the mat. So now make your way onto all fours. So as you ground down onto your hands and your knees, spread the fingers wide so you notice the webbing in between the palms. Spread the knees hip width distance apart, no wider, no shorter. You can let the front of the feet flat or curl the toes. Here we go, moving through a few gentle cat-cows. Tuck your chin to your chest, round. Inhale, look up. Again, tuck your chin to your chest, round. Inhale, look up. Again, tuck your chin to your chest, round your spine like a rainbow. Release your low back, your middle back, your upper back. Again, tuck your chin to your chest, round. Gently return back to a neutral position. Lengthen the right arm and left leg. You can stay here and notice if you're a little bit wobbly. Keep engaging everything down the midline. Stay here or back and grab hold of the ankle or the foot. Push the foot into the hand to open up the front body. Here we go. Five big breaths. Inhale. Exhale one. Inhale. Exhale two. Inhale. Exhale three. Inhale. Exhale four. Inhale. Exhale five. Gently replace the right hand and left knee onto the mat. Let's give it a try on the other side now. So you lengthen the left arm. You lengthen the right leg. Stay here as you keep engaging your core. Or do what you did on the other side. Bend the right knee. Maybe you can reach for the ankle or the front of the foot. I push the foot into my hand to open up my front body. Here we go. Five big breaths. Inhale. Exhale one. Inhale. Exhale two. Inhale. Exhale three. Inhale. Exhale four. Inhale. Exhale five. Good. Gently replace the hand and the knee back down. So lengthen the left leg. Pivot the left heel flat. I lean onto the right side of my body. I begin to tent my left fingers. When I feel completely confident, I'm gonna lift the left arm high to the ceiling, coming into gate pose. Here we go. Five big breaths. Inhale. Exhale one. Inhale. Exhale two. Keep grounding down through that back left heel. Inhale. Exhale three. Inhale. Exhale four. Inhale. Exhale five. Good. Gently replace your hand and your knee back down. I'm going to turn around so you can see me. We're going to do that same exact thing now on the opposite side. So lengthen the right leg, pivot the right heel flat, lean on to the left side of your body. Maybe you tent the right fingers. When you feel confident, lift your right arm high to the sky, coming into gate pose for five breaths. Inhale. Exhale one. Inhale. Exhale two. Inhale. Exhale three. Inhale. Exhale four. Inhale. Exhale five. Gently replace your hand and your knee back down. Everybody, we're going to tuck our toes. And we'll make our way into that upside down letter V shape. Downward facing dog. So as you settle into your down dog here, start to bend one knee at a time. Shake it out. Do whatever you can. Maybe shake your head yes, shake your head no. Good. Walk your feet to meet your hands at the top of the mat. Grab opposite elbows. Let your head and your neck hang heavy. And just sway side to side. It should feel like a nice release. Good, let the arms dangle. Again, just getting deep into the quad and the hamstring muscles here. Now reverse swan dive, your arms up high to the sky. I'm going to adjust the computer screen so you can see me. Reach the arms up high. Listen, interlace your hands up. And this time, let the palms face up. That way you can get a nice stretch in the obliques. Lean over to the right. Three breaths. Inhale. Exhale one. Inhale. Exhale two. Inhale. Exhale three. Good. Release which sides? Go ahead, lean over to the left. Inhale. Exhale, one. Inhale. Exhale, two. Inhale. Exhale, three. Good. Release. Cactus shape your arms and lean back. Stretch out your low back. Inhale. Exhale, one. Inhale. Exhale, two. Inhale. Exhale, three. Release. You can either come back into the down dog and do the vinyasa flow, or way back at home base, the vinyasa flow that's either knees, chest, and chin, or yogi push-up. Bend the elbows, glide your heart upward facing dog, and reach up your toes back under downward facing dog. Here we go, building our flow. Inhale, the right leg up high. Bend the knee, open up the hip. Take the right knee, tap the left elbow, shoot it back up. Good. Now, take the right knee to the right elbow using your obliques. Good. Shoot it back up. Take the foot in between the hands. Pivot the left heel at a 45 degree angle and reach your arms up high to the sky, coming into your warrior one. Three breaths in your warrior one. Inhale, exhale, one. Reaching your arms nice and long past the sides of your ears. Inhale, exhale, two. Inhale, exhale, three. Reach your arms apart in the air, warrior two. So it's a little bit more of a wider stance as you keep pulling away, the hands away from each other. Inhale, exhale, one. Relax the deltoids down your back. Inhale, exhale, two. Inhale, exhale, three. Now reverse your warrior. Left hand walks down your back thigh as you sweep the right arm up and overhead like an umbrella. You can always take the left hand behind your back. That way you can use more of your core, your choice, your practice. Inhale, exhale, one. Inhale, exhale, two. Inhale, exhale, three. Release. Cartwheel your hands back down onto your mat. Step the right leg back. You're at home base, down dog. Option to do the vinyasa. Bend the elbows as you come into plank. Glide your heart upward facing dog. Retuck the toes, down dog. I'm going to switch so that you can see me. We'll do that same exact sequence now on the left side. Inhale the left leg up, bend the knee, take the knee over to the right elbow, tap, take it over to the left elbow, tap, shoot it back up. Glide the foot in between the hands, pivot the right heel flat, come on up, warrior one, left side. Three breaths here, inhale, exhale two, inhale, exhale three. Release your hands into warrior two, so spread the arms like a butterfly. Inhale, exhale one, keep pulling them apart like saltwater taffy, inhale. Exhale, two. Inhale. Exhale, three. Here we go. Reverse a warrior. Right fingertips down your back thigh or behind your back as you sweep the left arm up and overhead. Inhale. Exhale, one. Inhale. Exhale, two. Inhale. Exhale, three. Release. Cartwheel the arms back down onto the mat. Step back, down dog, and wait. Or option to rinse it out. Bend the elbows. Heart upward facing dog. Tuck the toes back under. Down dog. Now, back to the right side as I switch again. Here we go. Right leg up, high to the sky. Listen, I'm gonna take the right leg. I'm gonna kick it over to the left side of my body. And I step my hips down and I reach my left arm high to the ceiling. My right hand is right next to my right hip. I push down through the soles of my feet and my right hand, and I lift the hips off the mat. We call this fallen triangle. Good, let's do that three times. Sit your glutes down on the mat. Good, now lift back up. One more time. Down on the mat, lift back up. Good, set your left hand next to your, back onto your mat, next to your right hand. Sweep the right leg up high to the ceiling. Glide it in between your hands, pivot your left heel flat. Here we go again, warrior one. Building onto our sequence. Exhale, warrior two.
peaceful warrior. Back fingertips to your thigh, right arm up and overhead. Here we go. This is where we add on. With that right knee still bent, you'll bend your forearm and your elbow. Set your forearm on top of your thigh. This is option one. Option two, set the right hand next to your right foot as you sweep the left arm to the ceiling. Stay here, and breathe for three big breaths. Or take your right hand about a foot in front of your big toe. Shift your weight into your hand, your right hand and your right foot, and maybe you can lift the left leg up to the ceiling, coming into your half moon, Ardha Chandrasana. You can always set the left hand next to the right foot to lift the back leg up in the air, wherever you're at. Let's give it three big breaths here. Inhale, exhale one, inhale, exhale two, inhale, exhale three. Beautiful efforts, everybody. Set your left hand down, set your right hand flat, and step back, down dog, and wait for vinyasa. Bend the elbows, glide your heart upward facing dog, reach up your toes, down dog. Let's push on the left side now. Inhale the left leg up. Now I'm gonna switch sides so you can see me. I'm gonna take the left leg, kick it through underneath my right armpit, and I sit my butt down as I lift the right arm up high to the ceiling. Good, now we're gonna lift our hips off the ground. So you push down through the soles of the feet and lift your hips off the mat. Sit your glutes back down. Good, two more, lift up. And one more, lift back up. Reset your right hand down on the mat. Kick your left leg up in the air. Glide the foot in between the hands. Pivot the right heel flat. Warrior one, left side. Here we go. Warrior two. Building onto our sequence. Reverse our warrior. Now, start to hinge at the hips. You set your forearm on top of your left thigh as you sweep your right arm high to the ceiling. You may stay here in your extended side angle, or maybe you could take the left hand down to the inside of the left foot, forming a T with the arms. Stay here, or shift your weight into your left hand and your left foot, and maybe you can lift the right leg off the mat, coming into your half moon. Keep flexing your right toes. It will help with your stability. You can always set the right hand down onto the mat if you need to for extra modification. Here we go, three breaths. Inhale, exhale one, inhale, exhale two, inhale, exhale three. Release the hand, release the foot onto the mat. Step back, down dog, and wait, or rinse it out, vinyasa. Come into plank. Knees, chest and chin, or chaturanga. Glide your heart, upward facing dog. Retuck your toes back under, downward facing dog. Everybody rest, child's pose. Wide knees, toes touching. Sink your hips to your heels. See if you can breathe deeply into your low back for 3 to 5 breaths. Inhale, exhale one. Inhale, exhale two, inhale, exhale three, inhale, exhale four, inhale, exhale five. Nice, everybody. Slowly walk your hands up to your hips. And now we'll make our way into camel. So as you come into camel, come standing on your knees and your shins. Spread your knees a little bit more than hip width distance apart. I begin by placing my hands on my low back or my kidneys. Push your pelvis forward. If you want to reach for your ankles or your heels, lean back and then let your throat face your ceiling for 5 big breaths here. Inhale, exhale one, exhale two, inhale, exhale three, inhale. Exhale four, inhale, exhale five. Release, come back up, place your hands on your hips, nice. And again, child's pose is the counter pose. So you want to release any tension in that lumbar spine for 5 big breaths here. Inhale, exhale 1, inhale, exhale 2, inhale, exhale 3, inhale, exhale 4, inhale, exhale 5. Nice, gently make your way onto the mat. So as you come onto the mat, make your way into a seated position on your mat. I'm just gonna adjust the computer screen so you can see me seated on the mat. As you arrive in a seated position on the mat, go ahead and cradle your right leg like a baby. Option one, you can grab hold of your right foot with your left hand and grab your right hand up. Place your right hand on top of your right knee and just cradle the leg side to side. It's a really nice hip opener. You can stay here. Another option to take, you can take your forearms underneath your right leg. Keep flexing your foot. It will help with the stability on your right knee. And this is a really great hip opener. Now, I know some of you are regulars in my class and we've worked on Compass in the past. So let's take it up a notch for those who want to take to another level. You take the right leg on top of your shoulder. You take your left hand to the outside of your right foot. I extend my right leg right next to my right hip. I use my foot as leverage to open up my thoracic spine. This is Compass Pose. You can stay here and look out underneath your left armpit. 3 big breaths here. Inhale, exhale 1, inhale, exhale 2, inhale, exhale 3. Slowly release the right leg down to the mat. So it took me a gazillion classes, and you know, I've been teaching yoga for years, so don't get frustrated. That's why they call this the yoga practice. Nothing happens overnight. So let's try it on the left side. Maybe you start like this, left hand to the left knee, right hand to the left foot, and just slowly cradle the leg side to side. It's a nice release in your hip flexors, the joints, in your ankles, your feet, and your hips. Or you can cradle the leg like we did on the right side. So I can take my forearms and I really just try to get the left leg close to my chest and I sit with the tall spine and just rock side to side. Feel free to stay here. Or maybe you do what we did on the other side. If you'd like to work on Compass Pose on this side, take the left leg, place it on top of your left shoulder, extend the left leg, extend the left hand right next to your hip. Take your right hand to the outside of your foot. Push the foot into the hand and use that to really open up the chest. 3 big breaths here. Inhale, exhale 1, inhale, exhale 2, inhale, exhale 3. Good. Slowly release the leg back down onto the mat with the soles of the feet together. Butterfly pose. So shake out the knees here for a bit. We tend to carry a lot of emotions in our shoulders, our hips, and a lot of tension in the head, neck, and shoulders. And we peel that away breath by breath in yoga. Inhale a tall spine and exhale forward fold over the soles of the feet. Baddha Konasana. 5 breaths here. Inhale. Exhale 1. Inhale. Exhale 2, inhale, exhale 3, inhale, exhale 4, inhale, exhale 5. Gently make your way back up. Go ahead and lengthen the legs straight out in front. Give them a nice little shake out. And with your legs straight out in front, inhale your arms up and forward fold. You can grab hold of the top of the toes, the ankles. You don't have to grab your legs at all. Just let your head, neck, and torso hang heavy over your straight legs. 5 breaths. Inhale. Exhale 1. Inhale. Exhale 2. Inhale. Exhale 3. Inhale. Exhale 4. Inhale. Exhale 5. Gently make your way back up. Make your way on to your mat laying down. So come laying down with bent knees. And
We'll make our way into bridge. So see if you can touch the heels. That's the measurement of how far away your feet are from your glutes. Push down through your forearms and lift your pelvis off the ground. Here we go. 5 breaths here. Inhale. Exhale 1. Inhale. Exhale 2. Inhale. Exhale 3. Inhale. Exhale 4. Inhale. Exhale 5. Gently release. Lower your pelvis down onto the ground. Hug the knees into the chest and just create some small little circles. Knees. Just to relieve any tension in the lumbar spine. Lift your legs straight up to the ceiling, making an L shape. If you have a shoulder stand, feel free to come into it. But stay here, both are the same therapeutic effects, whatever feels right, either shoulder stand or L shape. 10 breaths here. Inhale. Exhale 1. Inhale. Exhale 2. Inhale. Exhale 3. Inhale. Exhale 4. Inhale. Exhale 5, inhale, exhale 6, inhale, exhale 7, inhale, exhale 8, inhale, exhale 9, exhale 10. Lower the legs flat on the mat, and we'll make our way into the counter pose. So go ahead and bend your elbows and set your forearms flat. Puff up your chest and your heart, and release the crown of the head to the back of the mat with the throat facing up towards the ceiling. 5 breaths here. Inhale. Exhale 1. Inhale. Exhale 2. Inhale. Exhale 3. Inhale. Exhale 4. Inhale. Exhale 5. Good. Slowly release. Lay flat on your back on your mat. Lift your right leg to the ceiling. You can grab behind your calf or your ankle and keep flexing your left foot. Or, option to tip this up a notch, lift your head off the ground if you'd like to amplify the stretch. Here we go, 5 breaths, inhale. Exhale 1, move the spine, inhale. Exhale 2, inhale. Exhale 3, inhale. Exhale 4, inhale, exhale 5. Good, gently release. Give the right leg a gentle shake out and switch it up. So lift the left leg up. You can grab behind the knee, the calf, or the ankle. Option to lift your head off the mat. You don't have to do the same thing twice. Here we go. 5 breaths on this side. Inhale, exhale 1, inhale. Exhale 2, inhale. Exhale 3, inhale. Exhale 4, inhale. Exhale 5. Good. Gently release. Lower the leg flat onto the mat and shake it out. Bend the knees and now cross the right ankle over the left knee, coming into figure 4 with the legs. You could stay here with the left foot grounded or lift the left foot off the mat. You can interlace your hands around your left hamstring. Here we go, or calf, inhale. Exhale 1, inhale. Exhale 2, inhale. Exhale 3, inhale. Exhale 4, inhale. Exhale 5. Good. Gently release. Just give your legs a nice little stretch out before we make it over to the other side. Re-bend the knees with the feet grounded. Cross the left ankle over the knee. You can stay here in figure 4 or lift the right foot off the mat. You can interlace your hands and place them on top of your right leg. Inhale. Exhale 1. Inhale. Exhale 2. Inhale. Exhale 3. Inhale. Exhale 4. Inhale. Exhale 5. Nice. Shake out the legs here for a little. Now bring your arms into the letter T. Bend the knees into the chest. Flip the the knees over to the right as you look out over the left shoulder, coming into your reclined spinal twist. 5 breaths here. Inhale. Exhale, 1. Inhale. Exhale, 2. Inhale. Exhale, 3. Inhale. Exhale, 4. Inhale. Exhale, 5. Gently release and now lift the knees over to the left as you look out over the opposite shoulder. Here we go. Inhale. Exhale, 1. Inhale. Exhale, 2. Inhale. Exhale, 3. Inhale. Exhale, 4. Inhale. Exhale, 5. Give your legs a nice little stretch out across the mat. Shake them out. Now, bend the knees into the chest. Let the feet face the ceiling. You can grab any part of the legs, the ankles, the outsides of the soles of the feet, and just gently rock side to side. Activate the toes. It's a really nice way to massage your spine and your tailbone here. Also, the tissues behind the backs of your lungs. You may say, I'm a creeper. Gently release the legs straight out. Give them a nice little shake out across the mat. Go ahead, re-bend the knees into tight, tight, tight. The grip is tight. The expression on your face is tight. Everything feels so tense, tense, tense. Release. Shavasana. So get into a comfortable position on your mat where you can let your feet open to the opposite edges. Let your palms face the ceiling. Close your eyes and pretend that your body's shifting in the sand at the beach as you let gravity take over. Take your tongue, glide it to the top of your teeth. Then let your tongue settle down to the bottom of your jaw. Let your jaw completely relax. Relax your forehead, relax your cheeks. Relax the back of your neck and your throat. I hope someday you'll join. Draw the shoulder blades down your back and onto the mat. Relax your belly, relax your heart and your lungs. Relax your hips. Relax the thighs. Relax the backs of the knees and the kneecaps. Relax the calf muscles and the shins and the ankles, the Achilles heel, the feet, all 10 toes and fingers. Just surrendering to this very moment right here, right now. Practicing stillness. Slowly begin to deepen your breath. Start to wiggle your fingers and your toes. Go ahead and sweep your arms up and overhead, feeling like that first morning stretch of the day from the fingers to the toes. Bend the knees into your chest, hug them tight. Rock on to any side, your left or your right. In a fetal position, you can use your arm as a pillow if you wish. Just give yourself a moment to gather before making it back out into the real world. When you're ready, with your eyes still closed, meet me back in a cross-legged seated position on your mat. Let your palms come together at your heart center and bow your head down in gratitude. Just take a moment to seal your practice in this afternoon. Gratitude to one another for showing up. Gratitude for carving time out and making mind-body connections. Gratitude for practice that teaches us to remain peaceful in our minds and in our hearts, no matter what the circumstances.
Om Shanti, 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 peace, namaste. Thank you so much, everybody, for joining me this afternoon.